Every day is a new beginning. Take a deep breath, smile, and start again. Good morning, students, and welcome to your English language class 2. Today, we shall have the revision number 3, that is the remaining 3 units, that is interrogative sentences, question and answer, capital letters. Just a revision on it. What is an interrogative sentence? Let's read what's given to you. Sita has a doll. Has Sita a doll? Have you seen the difference between the two sentences? In the first sentence, it's just Sita has a doll with a full stop. It's a simple sentence. The next sentence is, has Sita a doll? It's with a question mark, so it is an interrogative sentence. Asking a question is known as interrogative sentence. The first sentence simply tells or states something. Such a sentence is called a statement. But the second sentence asks something. Such a sentence is called a question. The first sentence simply tells or states something is called a statement. Second one is just asking something is called a question. So we have seen in the first sentence it tells or states something, and in the second sentence we are asking something, so it's called a question. Note that at the end of the second sentence a question mark has been put. So we have seen a question mark in the second sentence. Compare the following sentence and notice which words changed their place. Let's compare the sentence and see which words are changing their place. I am ill today. Am I ill today? So the word which is am in the first sentence, it is second. And in the opposite sentence, the am word comes first. So am I ill today? The next one, he is busy now. Is he busy now? The doors are open. Are the doors open? She was present yesterday. Was she present yesterday? You were ill yesterday. Were you ill yesterday? Rama has a watch. Has Rama a watch? So students, these sentences are just interchanged. Only a word is interchanged, not whole sentence. Only a word is interchanged. Those words which are printed in blue are interchanged. And in the second part, we have seen the blue words have begun the sentence. The words printed in blue have begun the sentence. The last one is, they will visit Delhi on Wednesday. Will they visit Delhi on Wednesday? Important note is that in the question sentence, the verb is placed before the subject, noun or pronoun. He is busy now. Is a verb. He is a subject. So subject is placed before, verb is placed before the subject, noun or pronoun. Turn the following following statements into question is exercise 1. And exercise 2 is turn the following statements into questions. Let's see. Exercise 1, turn the following statements into question. I will just read few of them. They were in a great hurry. Were they in a great hurry? It will rain tomorrow. Will it rain tomorrow? Sita has no money. Does Sita have money? They are watching the match. Are they watching the match? Students, the sentence which you are writing in question should always end with a question mark. The cow is a useful animal. Is the cow a useful animal? The children are playing football. Are the children playing football? It is very hot today. Is it very hot today? These boys were absent yesterday. Were these boys absent yesterday? There will be a holiday tomorrow. Will there be a holiday tomorrow? They have no food in the house. Do they have food in the house? Let's see exercise 2 now. Turn the following statements into question as same. She was ill yesterday. Was she ill yesterday? She will come here tomorrow. Will she come here tomorrow? You are not well today. Are you well today? Are you not well today? Sikandar has a silver watch. Does Sikandar have a silver watch? They will go to Delhi tomorrow. Will they go to Delhi tomorrow? These boys are doing their lessons. Are these boys doing their lessons? There are no books with them. Are there any books with them? The basket is full of red roses. The basket is full of red roses. Is the basket full of red roses? You were late for school this morning. Were you late for school this morning? Let's go to the next unit, that is unit 19, question and answer. It's same as interrogative sentence. Read the following question and answers. What am I? You are a teacher. What do I do every day? You teach us. What am I doing now? You are teaching us. What did I do yesterday? You taught us. What shall I do tomorrow? You will teach us. So based on the picture given, we have asked question and answered to it. Now read this question and answers. You can give a positive or negative reply as you wish. Is he well? Yes, he is well. No, he isn't well. Are you well? Yes, I am well. No, I am not well. Do you drink coffee? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Do you like milk? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Have you done your lessons? Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Will you go to school tomorrow? Yes, I shall. No, I won't. Read the below given question and answers. What is your name? My name is Satish. How old are you? I am 10 years old. When were you born? I was born on 20th August 1993. What game do you like to play? I like to play football. Where do you live? I live at 10th Nehru Street. There are two exercises. Exercise 2 is to be done by yourself. Exercise 1 I'll be doing to you. Did she pass? No, she did not pass. Are you well today? Yes, I am well today. Is he at home? No, he is not at home. Is the train late? Yes, the train is late. Is she your sister? Yes, she is my sister. Do you play hockey? No, I don't play hockey. Do you like to play? Yes, I like to play. Can she swim? Can she swim? No, she can't swim. Did you work hard? Yes, I worked hard. Did he play well? Yes, he played well. Were you present? Yes, I was present. Has she come back? Yes, she has come back. Were they sleeping? No, they were not sleeping. Are these books yours? Yes, these books are mine. So the next unit, let us move to the next unit, capital letters. A sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. The guard waved the green flag. The train started. The begins with a capital letter T and ends with a full stop after the flag is full stop. Names of person begin with the capital letter. Ashok and his friend Raman came to see Mrs. Shah yesterday. So can you see the names of the person are in capital letters? Yes. Special names of towns, countries, places, rivers, mountains, etc. begin with the capital letter. Delhi is the capital of India, stands on the Yamuna. Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world. The names of the places, towns, cities always begin with a capital letter. The names of days and months all begin with a capital letter. Monday comes before Tuesday and after Sunday. December, January and February are the coldest months. So the days of the week and the months of the year all are in capital letter. The words I and God begin with a capital letter. I pray to God every morning. Let's do the summary. A sentence begins with a capital letter and ends with a full stop. Names of person begins with a capital letter. Special names of town, countries, places, rivers, mountains begin with a capital letter. The names of days and months all begin with a capital letter. The words I and God begin with a capital letter. Remember these 5 points where you have to begin the capital letter and end the full stop. Rewrite the following sentences by using capital letters. Mr. Brown came to see us on Friday. Mr. is and Friday both have to begin with a capital letter because it's name of person and day. It is the day in a week, Friday. So Mr. Brown came to see us on Friday. The largest city is in America, in New York. The largest city in America is in New York. The names of places. And the sentence should begin with capital letter, end with full stop. London is the capital of England. London is the capital of England. Begin with capital letter and the names of places, capital letter. My birthday is on Tuesday, the 22nd of March. Begin with the capital letter, my. Tuesday, begin with the capital letter. March, begin with a capital letter. Next one, Peter and Lily visited the Qutub Minar on Wednesday. Peter and Lily visited the Qutub Minar on Wednesday. Wednesday, Qutub Minar, Lily and Peter. This is name of person and place. So capital letter. Patel and Rajni went to see the Taj Mahal at Agra. Patel, Rajni, Taj Mahal, Agra. Name of person and place. The longest river in India is the Ganges. The longest river in India. India capital letter, Ganges. G capital. Mahatma Gandhi is called the father of nation. Mahatma Gandhi, name of person. Nation capital letter. Mrs. Green's dog was called Blackie. Mrs. Green, Blackie, all these are names, so it should begin with a capital letter. The name I am known by is Geeta Bali. The capital letter, Geeta Bali, it's the name of person. So it should begin with capital letter. The Ramayana is a holy book of the Hindus. The begin with a capital letter. Sentence, Ramayana, it's the name of a holy book of the Hindus. Lucknow is the capital of Uttar Pradesh. Lucknow and Uttar Pradesh both are the names of place, so it should begin with a capital letter. Students, I hope you have understood the 3 units. Interrogative sentence, question and answers, and capital letters. If you have any doubt, you can call me. I'll be available to you anytime. You are braver than you believe and stronger than you seem and smarter than you think. I repeat, you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. Thank you, students.